What is good, guys? Back with another small snake draft game. This time we have Ojama versus Sidumas, and Ojama has a lot of potential scarf for us. Keldeo, Lari, or Katana is going to be scarf. One of the three is also going to be the Z move user, and the Magina has to be assault vest. Helps him versus Coco. Helps him versus Greninja. I know he also has checks for Greninja and Keldeo. And it helps him to deal with better with opposing Magina. It's most likely going to be Zard-X. Not sure yet if it's a 3 attacks roost or if it's going to be a DD variant. And probably a defensive lander with rocks. So this is defensive core, and the other ones are like a bit more offensive. On the other side, we have a Mega Mawile squad with probably AV Tangrowth, mixed defensive Toxapex, either Scarf Greninja or Scarf Landorus, and then probably could be Z-move Coco. It could also be depending on either the Greninja or the Lander, which one of those two is not Scarfer. Could also be the Z-move user. So we do see Ojama lead off with Lander and Sidumas the same, and they're either gonna exchange rocks or HP Ice here. If you're Sidumas, you obviously want rocks up a bit more, I feel, because of for the Zard. It's really nice to have them up. So we do see we could have seen it at team preview, actually, or like after they sent out their Landorus, is what I meant, that Ojama's Landorus is slower. So we already knew from looking at team preview, Ojama's Landorus is most likely defensive. It also gets leftovers, that which confirms that it's a defensive Lando. And Sidumas Lando does not have lefties, which means it's either a Rocky Helmet variant or like some other offensive variant. I'm thinking it's a bit more offensive, like definitely some, it doesn't have to be Scarf, but it's definitely some sort of offensive variant, because it did not took the HP Ice that well, so it's not max HP is what I'm thinking. Unless it's max HP minus Spedef, but I'm not thinking that. I'm thinking he's probably either really speed invested, or like he could be like a Z-move or off-plate variant. So if Sidumas is not choice locked, he could get his rocks up. I'm pretty sure that Ojama is going to switch out here, because he can keep his Landorus for late to get up the rocks, and to like he can double it in later. It's nice to have it around because it's a ground type. That means Coco cannot spam its electric type moves. So Ojama is probably going to switch into maybe Keldeo or Kartana here, predicting like HP Ice or rocks again from Sidumas. Sidumas could, if I'm Sidumas, I would either U-turn or rocks, one of the two options. I would definitely not HP Ice, because it's pretty obvious that Ojama is not going to stay in with the lander. So like, depending on what he wants more, I mean, rocks are amazing because it hits the Zard for 50% up on switching, but U-turn momentum also wouldn't be bad, because Ojama does go Katana, and like, it is kind of hard for Sidumas to switch into Katana, and I guess Tangrowth would have been decent switch in, but depending on the Kartana set, if it's SD, Tangrowth is not the best answer. If it's a Z-move Kartana, so he does go to Mawile, threatens the Kartana with the Fire Fang. So Ojama is gonna have to switch out here into either Landorus or Magina, I guess. The thing is, if Magina gets worn down, then Coco and Greninja can become scary. So he does Ice Punch, he predicted the Landorus. That looked kind of weird because he went from a Fire Weak to a Fire Weak, but just having Land on the back, I think, made Sidumas click Ice Punch. Sidumas is now gonna click Fire Fang or whatever best move he has to hit the Magina, and I think Ojama's gonna Volt Switch. The thing is, yeah, Magina getting low means Greninja can potentially become scary later in the game. And same with Coco. But either the Kartana or the Keldeo, one of the two is going to be Scarf or the Lari. I'm not sure about it yet. So I guess he can still check the Greninja. But yeah, I assume this has to be AV looking at his team, then he's going to Volt Switch out. And he gets a crit, and now he can go into his Zard or his Landorus here. If he goes Landorus, that would mean he would get some leftovers, and he could potentially HP Ice trying to predict Sidumas to go into his Landorus, or he could just get up his rocks. And if he goes Zard, Zard is tough for Sidumas to switch into because his Landorus is already weakened. I'm pretty sure Sidumas should know that Zard X, that's like super obvious. because he doesn't have a T-Tar and Zedex is just better at the moment. And like, if it's Zardes Earthquake, which it should be, Zedex with Earthquake, Toxapex is not a great check, especially if it's SD or if it's DD that with Earthquake it can easily break the packs. So since the land was already weakened, I can definitely see Jama putting in work later in the game with his Zard. So he goes on the Landers to get some lefties, and he's like, I would definitely consider, like I said, HP icing here, because Sidiuma's Landris is slower, and if you catch that, there will be one Zard check out of the way. But I guess just rocking is safe here. But the thing is, if you rock here and Sidiuma goes into his Landris, then you kind of have to defog later if Sidiuma gets up his rocks. So that's probably not the smartest play to rocks. I guess U-turn would be fine, because it covers Sidiuma's going into Greninja on a potential HP ice, and it covers the Landris as well. It just gets momentum. I don't think he's gonna stay in with the Mawile. So he goes Greninja, that's why I thought U-turn was the better play. He did HP ice, which I agree kind of with, I said it first, but U-turn is overall the better play in my opinion, because it covers Lando and Greninja. Like, it pretty much covers whatever Sidiuma's did, but HP ice did not cover the Greninja play. Now Sidiuma can get up a spike here, or he can just like chip at the Kaleo. I assume Majama is now going to switch into the Kaleo, and Magina is already kind of weakened, so I don't think he wants to go to that. Yeah, I think the Magina was pretty low, if I recall correctly, from Iron Head, from Mawile. Iron Head is not that common. That's not that common at all, yeah. Yeah, he should go into Kaleo here. No matter what Kaleo he is, unless the Greninja has extra sensory, he can check it pretty well with that. Now, if Sidiuma has Spike, I think he should just click Spike. I don't think Ojama's gonna sack his Landers. It's still pretty nice to have, just so Coco cannot spam its electric moves, and to have something to hit the pack super effective, and it also checks the Mawile. So now Kaleo is in, and Sidiuma's is most likely gonna switch into his Pex or his Tangrowth. So if I'm with Jama here, I would probably double out into something that covers both. Does he have a double that covers both Zardex or Lando? I guess I would have considered doubling into Zard. They covered the Pex and the Tangrowth. Mm-hmm. But Landros is understandable, because he wants to get up his rocks, is what I would guess, and he doubles it in to get some extra leftovers. So Sidiuma's is now gonna either HP Ice or knock off here, is my guess. Mm-hmm. He does knock off to get rid of the Landers lefties. And Ojama is probably gonna U-turn out here into either Lari or Zard. Does he need his Landers? I mean, his Landers would die to HP Ice. He does have knockoff, so that's cool. Okay, I did not expect him to have knockoff. I expected him to U-turn out. Knockoff is cool to get rid of like assault vest on Tangrowth to help Magina or like Kaleo or like Lari, like especially Lari. Lari's Draco is gonna do more now, which means Tangrowth cannot check it that well. Yeah, Lari is the best example. At first I was gonna say Kaleo can now do more with special attacks, but that's not a good example, because Kaleo also gets checked by Pex, and Scald is also resisted by Tangrowth anyway. But Lari is a good example. Lari can destroy Pex with Psyshock or Psychic, depending on if it's Scarf or Specs. If it's Specs, it's gonna destroy the Pex. Now as he does go, also by the way, Sidiuma's did Sludge Bomb, I think predicting the Charizard on turn 9. So he does go now on the Lari predicting. I don't know if he predicted the Gigarin, but he does get the play correct. And he can probably click Psychic or Psyshock here, depending on if he's Scarf or Specs. The way he brought this out, I guess he could be Specs, because he's like... Yeah, I'm thinking... I know Jama has used Specs Lari before. I think it was an ulti. And it just seems... It makes sense to me with knocking off with Lando the AV on Tangrowth, and then Lari can beat it better, can beat it down pretty easy with Spec Psychic. That just makes sense. Sidiuma's just has to stay in here and click knockoff. I don't think he can risk anything. I think if we already know that Sidiuma's Greninja is most likely choice Scarf, as we do see there was a Specs Lari. We could also really tell that from the damage it did 84. Even though the AV was already knocked off, it's still a Spadef Tangrowth. I know it doesn't have great Spadef, but if you might put Max Spadef or near Max Spadef, it's still decent, even though the base set is pretty bad. So he does keep it in the bag, goes into his Coco. He's gonna take a lot, like 50-60% is my guess. Oh, he does Hidden Power. Oh, wait, what was that? Hidden Power Fire? I think it was Hidden Power Fire trying to predict the Mawile, maybe? I guess maybe Hidden Power Fire trying to catch the Mawile. Hidden Power 5 would make sense on specs to hit stuff like Ferrothorn and Scizor. Mm-hmm. So Seedumas can, like, if he's physical, he can U-turn out here. And if he's special, he can just click Dazzling Gleam. See, Aojama just sexes Meganer, and we do see the U-turn, so it's could still be mixed Coco with like U-turn, Wild Charge, HP Eyes, and Roost slash Taunt, or it could be fully physical. Fully physical would be Wild Charge, U-turn, Roost, and then either Taunt or Brave Bird. Brave Bird is not really common. So it does go into Pex. You would only run. Yeah, I'm gonna talk about the Coco a bit later, I guess. So you just go Pex, which lets the Lani in. Yeah, basically what I was trying to say earlier, we know that the Lando changed that move, so the Lando is not the Scarfer, and the Greninja went for Spikes, and Greninja has to be the Scarfer, in my opinion. I don't think he scarfed Coco, that would seem really weird. So the Lani is probably just gonna Psychic. I don't think Seedumas would risk. I think he's just gonna Psych his Tangrowth. Yeah, because there was no way he's gonna risk switching hard into Greninja. So now he goes into Greninja and he can just Dark Pulse or Ice Beam depending on what he has. Aojama is most likely gonna go to Keldeo here. Because of even if the Katana is the Scarfer, that means the Keldeo would not be Scarf. Katana cannot hard switch into Greninja because it has bad speed death, so he's forced to go Keldeo, I'm pretty sure. And Lari is still nice to have for the Pex. And for the Lando, outspeeding those two and dealing massive damage to Seedumas' team. So Keldeo seems like the play to make here. As it is at full, so after Spike it's at 88 and it can take pretty much everything Ninja wants to do. Let's see if he has a surprise extra sensory. No, he just Ice Beams. So that does some nice chip damage as the Keldeo is either gonna fire off a Scald here if it's Choice Scarf, or if it's not Choice Scarf he could Calm Mind and be a Zemo variant. Also, if he's Choice Scarf, he could potentially double out into Zard here, predicting the Toxapex. The Toxapex is definitely coming out here for Seedumas. He's not going to stay in with the Greninja. He's locked into Ice Beam. He still wants to Scarf Greninja around to potentially maybe check DD Zard X later in the game. And just as a speed control in general for stuff like Scarf Katana. So Pex is coming out here 100%. So Aojama can do whatever he has to take advantage of Pex, which would be either doubling into Zard with Earthquake, Zard X, or doubling to land, or trying to fish for the burn, or Calm Minding up. So he does have Calm Mind, okay. And Pex comes out. So now this is probably a Taunt, Calm Mind, Z-move, Keldeo. The thing is, if it's Breakneck Blitz, it's going to be able to do a lot to the Pex, but if it's Hydro Vortex, the Pex is going to eat it up. But if the Keldeo has Taunt, that means, I think Seedumas is now going to spam Scald, because Calm Mind, Z-move, Keldeo, they tend to run Taunt. So I think Seeduman knows that they run Taunt and he's gonna break that and Scald and try to get the burn. But even if he gets the burn, the Keldeo, since the burn got nerfed, I think Keldeo will be able to beat the Pex 1-1 and eventually scare it out with Taunt, Calm Minding up and having a Z-move. So he does hard Z-move. I think Seeduman's just Scalded? Predicting the Taunt, yeah. He did just Scald. He does get a crit, which is lucky, but he doesn't get a burn. So now Aojama should Taunt here to prevent the Pex from healing. And I think Seeduma is just gonna Scald again, knowing that the Taunt is most likely coming. And I do think that the Keldeo, yeah, does beat this Pex 1-1. Does he get the burn? He does get the burn. Okay, so that was well played by Seeduma. And he still is kind of forced to, like, I guess he can stay in one turn, but he kind of has to sack something, like, maybe. How much would plus one Secret Sword do, like, or Scald? Hydro Pump, I mean, Hydro Pump also risks missing if you're Aojama. Basically, if Seeduma wants to keep his Toxapex healthy for the Zard slash for the Cartana, his option here would be sacking something and then coming in with either Greninja or Coco to revenge the Keldeo. So he can either stay in, which would mean that his Toxapex would get weakened, or he can sack something. Exactly, he does sack the Mawile to the Secret Sword. And now he can go to Coco or Greninja to... Actually, Greninja probably not. Probably Coco to revenge the Keldeo. Oh, his timer is super low. As he does go into Coco, and he's gonna Wild Charge, or does he have if he has a mid ground play that hits Landorus and Keldeo, then he can also click that. Keldeo is still kind of valuable as it outspeeds the Landorus. And so he does go in his own Landorus, as Shiyuma does have Brave Bird, which is for Venusaur and Tangrowth, I guess. So he's probably a fully physical Coco. He could still have HPS, but I'm guessing he might be fully physical. So Zard comes out, and Zard is probably gonna Mega Evolve and Dragon Dance, as it can now Earthquake the packs. Shiyuma's might predict Earthquake and go into Landro here to get the Intimidate off, but I think Gojama wins this game now with Zardex. Yeah, he could either Earthquake just to heavily damage the packs predicted in the Haze, or he could Dragon Dance again, predicting Shiyuma's to pivot into Landris. So he does have Baneful Bunker, which is, it sounds like a bad move, but it can be useful in some scenarios. Because if you go for a contact move, you get poisoned, and you can also potentially scout for like Trick with Baneful Bunker, and you can also get extra Black Sludge. Slash, if the opponent doubles on a Black Sludge, it could also help. On a Baneful Bunker, my bad. But I don't know why Gojama did it again. I guess he predicted the Landris, but he had to fear the Haze, so I think I would have just Earthquaked. But you can see, you guys can see, Earthquake does 45. It does a good chunk, and now you can just Dragon Dance again. The Pax is most likely gonna recover here, and at plus one, Earthquake is gonna do like 65-ish, maybe a bit more, 70 even. Okay. So you guys can see the Pax is eventually forced out here. Shiyuma's is most likely gonna switch into Landris, but Zard, Gojama can just DD here with his Zard. Because if Pax recovers, it doesn't matter. Earthquake at plus one is still gonna do a lot the next turn. Even if Landro comes up to Intimidate, he still is back at neutral because he Dragon Dance that turn, and since the Landorus is already weakened, it's most likely gonna die to Flare Blitz. So, and Shiyuma's cannot pivot between Pax and Landro that well because rocks are up. Rocks being up means even on the turns that Zard does not attack the Landorus, Landro still gets worn down from the hazard chip damage. Otherwise, Shiyuma could potentially outplay the Zard pivoting between Lando and Pax. Also, if he had leftovers on his Landorus and he pivots it, plays it perfectly, that would be really nice, but he does not have lefties. We don't know its item yet on Landorus. But yeah, Flabbitzing was completely fine and play by Gojama, as Earthquake still kills from his range, which means exactly Shiyuma knows that it pivots back into Landorus. But see, Gojama can just Dragon Dance because he does not lose anything. If the Pax stays in, he still can Earthquake next turn. If the Pax switches out, he can just Flare Blitz now again. Or Dragon Claw as a mid ground if he has that. I guess he's Flare Blitz Earthquake DD maybe. Maybe he doesn't have Dragon Claw. That could be it. So now he can just Dragon Dance again. And I don't think the Lando can come in again because I think the Lando dies to rocks. If I recall correctly, it was too low to come in again. I haven't looked at the health. It was pretty low. But yeah, Dragon Dance again here is definitely the fine play. Also, if Gojama has all these speed boosts, he obviously outspeeds the Scarf Greninja, and I think he just wins with the Zard. Like, I don't see what he loses from Dragon Dancing, even if Shiyuma predicts that and goes for Haze. It's not bad for Gojama. He's still completely fine. He can the next turn then Earthquake or DD again. If he, like, let's say he DDs and he gets Haze down, it's completely fine. He doesn't lose too much. Rocks being up on Lando, not having lefties, just made it so Landorus is like, yeah, I already mentioned it. Shiyuma's cannot pivot infinitely between Lando and Pax. Lando thankfully does not have regen on top of Intimidate. Imagine Lando having regen and Intimidate, it would be so broken. But yeah, you guys can see he does die to rocks. So if he DDs here, which he did, I think now he just wins with the Zard, because Earthquake is going to kill the Pax. He has to Baneful Bunker here, and he has to maybe get a triple Baneful Bunker to get enough Black Sludge recovery to lift the Earthquake. But I don't think he's going to be able to do that. So Earthquake is going to kill the Pax, and it's also going to kill the Coco and Greninja, and the game is over. He has 3 speed boosts. He does outspeed Scarf Greninja, obviously. So yeah, this Zard is definitely getting something. So Pax just dies. The crit did not matter. Unless he gets a super low roll, maybe. And now he can either click Flare Blitz or Earthquake to finish off the Greninja and the Coco. Flare Blitz might even be a bit stronger than Craig because of its Tough Claws boosted, but I'm not 100% sure about that. But he just clicked Flare Blitz, and he can click Flare Blitz or Earthquake, and Gojama's gonna win this game with its Zard. Thank you guys for watching. It's pretty late here, good god. I will have more content in the next days. And yeah, maybe some guest uploads from my BTB. But mostly it's myself. I'm putting in the work for you guys here. Hope you all enjoy these uploads. Smash that like button if you want to see more. And like, I'll keep putting in the work for you guys if you see that you enjoyed, obviously. And yeah, props to Ojama. I think he played well. And peace out, friends.